Hello everybody, this is Bob here with a new video. Today I'm going to be doing blue black mill in modern. All credit goes to Jason Chung for the deck list, and I'm definitely going to be consulting his sideboard guide as I've just picked up this deck this week. I think it's actually a pretty new deck to modern, or I guess it's been around for a while, but it's kind of been like a fringe tier 3, tier 4 deck. And with the recent addition of mission briefing, I think it's possible that this is like another like solid modern deck. I don't want to say tier one, but possibly tier two. So what we got going on is a mill deck that is pretty interesting to me. After watching Jason play the deck and playing the deck myself, this deck is not similar to burn. Obviously, you have some burn elements in that you're just trying to, mill your opponent for 50 cards. So you have cards like Glimpse of the Unthinkable and Archive Trap, but in overall you only actually play 15 mill spells. So just think about a burn deck, if they like, only played 15 burn spells, it would be a completely different deck. I think of this deck more as a blue-black control deck that seeks to like basically delay and stall the opponent, and then draw a bunch of cards with Visions of Beyond, and then finish off the opponent from there. So it's more of a blue-black control surgical, like lantern-esque hybrid deck than a burn deck, but it definitely takes elements from each. So that's what makes it super interesting to me, and it's very fun to play and very challenging to play too, is what I found. So going through the deck tech, let's just go, I guess, in order of like kind of the most powerful cards. So Archive Trap is one of the reasons to play this deck. If they search their library, you get to mill them for 13, which is approximately like slightly better than like 5 damage. So 5 damage for 0 mana is just obviously broken. So this is the best card. Obviously, it does rely on your opponent searching their library. So we do play Field of Ruin. So if they have any non-basics, then we can force them to search. If they're playing a deck like humans and they're less likely to have, tutor effects themselves, you can usually force them. So that's a big one. Glimpse is also, 10 mana, 10 mil for 2 mana. So it's pretty powerful. I alluded to this earlier, but mission briefing is like kind of what ties this deck together now. Like some of the time, mission briefing is just going to be like the mill spell that finishes your opponent off. And because the way it's templated, it's not like Snapcaster Mage, which gives flashback, which for Archive Trap would just be 5 mana, but it lets you cast the card. So you can mission briefing an Archive Trap for 0 mana if your opponent activated the trap card mode. So pretty interesting. Some of the time, as I mentioned, mission briefing is just going to flash back a glimpse or an archive trap for the win. But enough of the time, you're just going to be using it as a utility spell to kill off another creature or, draw 3 cards. Which is, again, another one of the strengths of this deck is Visions of Beyond. Like, everybody knows Ancestral Recall is broken. When you're able to effectively chain them, it just gets, like, really fun really quickly. So the other mill spells in this deck are Hedron Crab, which is basically the best 1 mana mill spell there is. And Mesmeric Orb, which is also pretty powerful. But you'll see actually, one thing I like about this deck is like you actually side out Crab or Orb, depending on the matchup a lot, because a lot of people will bring in a bunch of like artifact hate or removal spells for Crab, and then you can just take them out and then basically leave your opponent with a bunch of dead cards. So I thought that was an interesting thing. Going through the rest of the list, you got some brutality for life gain, board control. Counter spells can be an issue, so we have a little bit of discard as well, a little bit of removal, and then surgical extraction is kind of the last piece of the deck. A lot of decks in modern use their graveyard, for example, like Dredge or Arclight Phoenix decks, and surgical is a way to make it so that like when you're milling your opponent, you can actually strategically disable their deck by hitting key pieces of it. And so the one change I made from Jason's list was I cut out an island just to go up to 4 surgicals because I think it's just a very powerful effect and just wins the game against so many linear decks in the format. It's kind of the reason to play this deck is against a deck like Tron or Valakut, you take the namesake card and their deck basically doesn't function at all. And so getting to play, up to 7 copies post-board is really powerful. We also play Bridge as another stalling component, which can be really good against a deck like Humans or Spirits. Now going on to the sideboard, we have some bounce spells. Leyline of Sanctity is a big problem for the deck, so you need to have a good way to remove it. Then the rest of the sideboard, honestly, I forgot to mention Crypt Incursion, but Crypt Incursion is also an amazing card that is also a pseudo win con because Some of the time you just gain like 30 life, 40 life with this card, and then there's just no way for your opponent to kind of catch back up. So then they'll eventually just mill out. So it's almost a pseudo win condition. So the sideboard is kind of basically the exact same cards in the main deck, which is totally bizarre. But how it works is like you just side out, you know, whatever might be bad in the matchup, whether it's removal or crab or orb or bridge, and then bring in more of the other cards that are actually good in the matchup. So that's essentially the sideboard. It's actually pretty straightforward. You do have a couple cards that aren't in the main deck, like Damnation and Knight of Souls Betrayal for some of the creature matchups. But it's a very interesting deck, and I'm excited to see how it plays. I think I covered everything. Last couple cards would be Oboro. So it's a way to re-trigger Landfall, as well as helps to trigger Fatal Push. And then Sheldock Isle, which lets you cast a card for free. I expected Sheldock to be better in this deck, but it's pretty easy to mill the first 20 cards and trigger Visions from Beyond. It's a lot harder to mill, like, I guess the first, you know, 40 cards to trigger Sheldock Isle. So it's not as good as I thought it would be, but it's still, you know, a good two of to have. This deck doesn't have that many one drops, so it's pretty happy just playing a tap land on turn one. So I think that's everything. Let's get started. Hey everybody, welcome to round one. We are on the draw. We kept a one lander, but has two Visions of Beyond to cycle, so hopefully we get there. Okay, Relic for Progenitus is interesting. So, like, normally I would guess Scred, but he didn't play a Snow-Covered Mountain, so it must be some other deck. I'm going to lead with a Watery Grave so I can trigger Landfall next turn. And the thing with this deck is you never want to F6 because you want to, like, always bluff that you have, like, Archive Trap or Surgical. Burn Mirror. Is he a burn deck? I doubt it because Relic would be a really bizarre inclusion in a burn deck. Right. We just gained 3 life. Implement of Combustion. I don't know what this card does. Deals 1 damage to a player. Okay. I'm really curious what's going on now. Okay, so we just drew a trap. Yeah, I'm going to play Crab. And then I'm going to mill him and fetch an island. Okay, so it looks like it's like a weird, it looks like it's a Shrapnel Blast burn deck. So we will have to be monitoring our life total. This is not great because I think burn is generally a favorable matchup because you can Crypt Incursion them, but I don't know if this list has creatures and I don't know if it has a way to, I don't think it has fetch land, so that just makes Archive Trap bad. And luckily, looks like he's playing some non-basics. So, gross. Okay, so it's like an artifact burn deck. So we can at least Field of Ruin, his Darksteel Citadel, so we can trigger the trap. But I think we're in pretty bad shape. Gotta love Modern. I think about just over 80% of decks will shuffle their library for you, but some of them don't. So when they don't, that's when it's a problem. All right, well, I guess I'm just going to glimpse here and hope we survive a little bit longer. He is out of cards, so next turn we'll be able to recall. But I guess he has Chromatic Stars. Oh, okay, he does have a creature. Okay. We'll take 2 here. Just start with a draw three. Still no land. Let's try that again. Yes, I will play a crab. Yeah, we really need to draw a Field of Ruins soon. I will dump. Let's see. Discard. He does have some creatures, so I'm going to keep the Crypt Incursion. I guess I don't need the third Mission Briefing. Or actually, no, we don't need Ensnaring Bridge. There's no way we're going to empty our hand in time. But we probably won't get to cast our third Mission Briefing either. Okay, well, okay, you just exiled everything, so we went up to the Crypt Incursion, which is not great. Alright, I think we're pretty dead. Now, had we been able to cast these Archive Traps, we would have won, but fortunately, it's not a burn deck that shovels his library, so... we even do, like, even if we hit Brutality, we can't cast it because we only have one black mana. So, I mean, I guess it could lead off Glimpse, or sorry, Mission Briefing, just to see what we get. Yeah, why not? Okay, so I guess in this way I could hit Brutality, but we missed. So, do I want Inquisition this turn, or Glimpse? I think I'm just going to Glimpse this turn and pray. Because there's just so many things that beat us, whereas if we mill twice, we can win next turn. Like, I wouldn't say it's by any means likely, but it's hypothetically possible. Mox Opal too, lovely. Okay, we can't even beat that, so we're going to scoop. Alright, Burn with no fetch lands is going to be a pretty hard matchup. I'm going to take out the traps. Take out Field of Ruin. Inquisition, push, Brutality. Gosh, everything is just so bad. Search goals aren't good either. Like, all of these cards are, like, pretty awful. This is tough. I'm thinking about just bringing back the Fields of Ruins and Archive Traps. It's so bad, too, because I just don't have too many targets. Like, I could play Extirpate and Surgical, but it's only good if you get stuff in their hand. This just seems like a really bad matchup. So, yeah, I mean, it's between Extirpate and Surgical and Field Trap. I'm just going to go with Field Trap because it just mills much quicker. It's not a good plan, but it is what it is. I'll bring in Damnation. Let's give this a shot. So we do want to hit our second land drop, so I'm just going to end step vision, I think. Rift Bolt. We hit, play crab, and then I'll just play this tapped. I think the way he's built his deck, it probably makes it slower than a burn deck. But the fact that he doesn't search makes up for that. He has four cards left in his hand, so we got play Orb, or we can play Inquisition here. I guess we don't have the most mana, and hopefully he'll still have a card next turn. But, I don't know, Inquisition can hit something like a Shrapnel Blast. Yeah, I don't know, I'm just going to play the Orb. Because we're a little tight on mana. That's my dog Tully. Oh, we're almost dead. So that's fun. Alright, Brutality is a good draw. I will play it and escalate. Discarding. Murderer's Cut. Right, so leaving him with a relic. So, let's see. His hand's just a relic. Sacrifices the implement. Cycles through more burn spells. This is like a burn-tron hybrid. I like that he's using all his mana every turn. I wonder if he sided out his creatures. Seventeen cards in his graveyard. So close. I think I just Inquisition and Vision this turn. Let's lead with the Inquisition. Like, don't think we necessarily need it to draw three cards. So, 18. Searing Blaze, he does need another land. But that's fine. We're just going to cycle this for one. Drew of Brutality. So, his hand's just a relic. Cycle that. Soulscar Mage, which plays right into our brutality. Escalate again. Discarding Fatal Push. Then I will fetch Watery Grave tapped. Right, I think we're in good shape now. We draw a land, we can mission Briefing the Brutality, and we can also just Glimpse. And we're at 8 life, so he'll need two, at least two burn spells to kill us. And if we draw something like a Crypt Incursion, we just win. Right, there's no hand again. Right, so I guess I'll just glimpse him. Okay, that was a nice win to steal. Still not sure about like surgical versus archive traps. They're both just really bad. But like I was lucky not to really draw any, but I just think like if I am able to trigger the trap, it's just so much more powerful. So give it a shot. And Modern just like has maybe a core like 30 decks, but then on top of that, there's like 30 variations on those decks, and then on top of that, there's another like 40 other decks. So there's like 100 decks in Modern. It's ridiculous. Sounds fine. Think our opponent diluted his deck by having all these artifacts. I also don't know why he would choose to just bolt turn one. But it is what it is. Implement Lava Spike. Watery Grave. And hopefully I hit a land for the Crypt Incursion. It looks like we hit two creatures, so I guess we'd want to potentially gain more than six. All right, so he got off his combo of Implement Shrapnel Blast. And he has no more land, so that's not a good sign for us. We hit a land. So he only has, yeah, one, two creatures. I I guess I'll just play a land and pass. And we can end-stepped the Crypt Incursion. And if he plays a creature, we can kill it. Yeah, the other fun thing about Archive Trap is like, okay, so he played the Citadel, which I don't know if it's good for us, given that he didn't have... Alright, well, hopefully he doesn't have a Shrapnel Blast. Yeah, I guess we just Crypt Incursion here. Like, we could Mission Briefing, but it's like nothing we could flash back, so it would just be a Scry 2. Just cast it. Do you have the Shrapnel Blast? Well, looks like he does. Okay. Well, we were quite a ways from winning. Welcome back for round two. We are on the draw. And this hand is fine. Click burn again. Yep. Basically, it's Scalding Tarn. I guess it could be Burn. I guess we're going to Shock and Fatal Push. Alright, okay, so it could be Blue and Phoenix, which is what I would expect now. Your visions. Another surgical. So he did put two cards on top, so I'm mildly, I guess I'll just play Glimpse. And we have Visions from Beyond to potentially benefit, and if we mill a Phoenix, we have Surgical Extraction, so. So we did mill a Phoenix. Hey, they're milling themselves for us. That's nice. Opt. All right. How many are in his hand? Not to come back. Alright, so his hand is Drake, Charm, Opt, Delta. He's only playing. Alright, so he's for win conditions left, he has one Swift Spear and four Thing in the Ice. So we're gonna surgical his Drake. There's 17 cards in his graveyard, so we're very close. So, let's see. We can Field of Ruin his Steam Vents, put him up to 18, and then pay a black. So I guess it gives him a mana to opt, but then he spends it to. It doesn't matter as much. So if we Field of Ruin him and he casts opt, he goes to 19 cards, and then if he casts something else, he goes to 20. So I think it's worth doing. I guess, this now so he doesn't have visit charm. We can leave the Drake in his graveyard. Right, so basically he has Swift Spear and Four Thing in the Ices to kill us with from 12th life. There's the opt. Delta. Right, now he's at 20. That's good for us. He's gonna cast looting here probably. Start with a recall. Now we can go crab into brutality. Because the creatures that he has aren't going to die to brutality, so I think I like that. Although, what modes would we do? Like, if we do both modes, we discard mission briefing. Don't love. It's flashing back recalls at this point. So I could just do one mode. Could just do one mode. Yeah, alternatively, I could just cast Visions from Beyond. You know, I think we have enough cards, so I am just gonna escalate. He's not, he doesn't really have hard counter, so I think we're gonna have enough spells to beat him with. Both kill the crab. Is it charm as sort of a counterspell mode? I'll take the charm here. Bolt, thing in the ice. Crypt Incursion. He only has. He has two creatures in his graveyard. All right, well, we'll start with a recall. And I might honestly just fatal push his thing in the ice. Okay, so he just scooped. Sideboard plan against Phoenix. We want to take out the Crypt Incursion, Ensnaring Bridge, Crab, Orb. They bring in things like a braid. We want to bring in brutality. echoing truth, dismember, extirpate, acquisition. Fatal push. Then we need one more card, I guess. So it's between Crypt Incursion, which is really not that good because they don't play that many creatures, and Damnation or Set Adrift. I'll try Damnation. And the most important thing this matchup is having a Surgical for their Phoenixes. Everything else you can handle pretty easily, so we have that, so this is a good hand. Starting with Serum Visions. We will need another land, but hopefully that works out for us. Alright, I'm pretty happy playing Drago. If we can hit our land drops. Could just fire off a Surgical here, but we'll wait to draw a card first. Brutality. That's fine. Play that. I think there's a good chance it gets countered. Oh, okay. Well, let's take his Dispel and we can Surgical it. Or extirpate it. And he won't be able to counter it. So his hand will be Dispel, Loot, Gut, Bolt, Opt. We kept the steam vents on top? Or, okay, you gotta keep the thing in the ice on top. That makes more sense. Alright, so I think I start with an extirpate. He is going to be able to flip the thing in the ice, I believe. He sign in anything peculiar? Nope, just Ceremonious Rejections, which we took out all of our colorless cards. So that's good for us. Alright, so he just has a bunch of burn spells now. Shell Dock. Um, guess we'll keep a fatal push. And we can pass here. Start with the looting. Another looting. So he's gonna gut shot us, and then we can exile the Phoenix. He's not searched all game. And it's just a lightning bolt, so we can surgical that too. Alright. What's our sequencing here? So we could. I'm trying to think of if there's a way we can surgical the bolt in his hand without paying two life. I don't think there's a way. Because pay the mana for surgical, we can't cast our Fatal Push. And if we Field of Ruin, that's going to give him a line to cast the bolt anyways. So maybe we don't play the surgical. We are at 6 life. That is pretty low. I mean, I could surgical bolt, go to 4, then archive, then Field of Ruin, Fatal Push, Archive Trap. I think that's the play. It's weird, just like all the surgical's doing is gaining 1 life, but he does deal damage in chunks of 3. It does leave him hellbent. He has 40 cards in his library. We can come back in brutality. I think I'm okay with that. Leave the ones in his graveyard, because he doesn't have any graveyard stuff. And it'll help for our graveyard count. Then we can Field of Ruin. Swamp. Fatal Push. So this next turn, we're probably going to cast Brutality just to gain some life. I think those are the only modes we need. Gain life, like, Inquisition, he would have played anything. Let me just double check real quick what counter spells were left in his deck. So it's literally just so there's Is It Charm? So Kniffen Is It Charm. I guess Inquisition doesn't really get any better. So I'm trying to discard. Yeah, that's fine. We'll fire off Inquisition. So what is he gonna do? Loot or counter it? Okay. No. Okay. And I guess we're just going to glimpse him because the brutality, he can kill a Swift Spear. And we took all his bolts, right? So we can safely go down to one, to three. Yeah. So we'll mission briefing the glimpse. I guess, could he have something like, he's gonna play Grackling Drake? Nice. That's a good way to go out. Okay, cool. I guess he could have had something like Gutshot Swift Spear. So I probably shouldn't have taken that line, but things to be aware of. We're on the draw yet again. It's not great, but I'm gonna try it. It's possible this is a mulligan. I haven't played this deck to know for sure. Like, we're recycling the first visions, trying to hit a black source, and if not, we can Field of Ruin. We have Mesmeric Orb for our second turn play. So, yeah, I mean, this hand depends wildly on how good Crypt Incursion it is. Oh, so many people are playing this blue-red Phoenix deck online. Like, I would not be shocked if we're playing against it again. And I think it is a very good deck. I think Mill is favored, but I do think it depends on having Surgical. Because Phoenix is the only scary thing in their deck, and you have seven Surgicals post-board to answer it. Like, stuff like Thing in the Ice, you can just manage with your removal. Okay, so play. Think we're supposed to cycle this other vision. Like we could play Crab or Orb, but we really want to hit our third land next turn in case it's not a black source. Vision's the only card that gets us a card deeper. So I'm just gonna cast it here. Because the thing in the ice, it's just like has such a high likelihood of flipping. guess I needed a couple too many things to go right. I mean, I guess I just really needed a black source, and I had stuff to do for the first couple turns against like a slower deck. So against a slower deck, this hand is fine, but most of modern is not slow. Oh God, if he has a Phoenix, we pretty much just lose here. That's why this Phoenix deck is so good, is it can win on like turn four, and it has just bundles of interaction with creatures. And obviously, you can sideboard. I even saw a list flashing white for Stony Silence. Okay. Fiery Temper, we can beat. Play around. Is it Charm? Pyromancer Ascension. It's interesting. Just a really tough spot because we want to hold up Crypt Incursion for Phoenix, but in the meantime, Pyromancer's Ascension can beat us. So I'm just going to play a Crab and Mill because he kept two on top, so presumably those are pretty good. And see if it mills a Phoenix, and then we can definitely hold up Crypt Incursion if it does. So, yeah, we have to pass here. Now he's an active Ascension. I'm not sure how hard that's going to be to beat. I assume it's going to be pretty difficult, but we'll see. At least he's milling himself for us. He chose not to copy it. That's actually pretty interesting. So Pyromancer Ascension not doing the most right now. I don't think it's correct to choose to not to copy it, but see where he goes. I don't mind if he hits the crab. I guess he's just gonna 6S. It's pretty good. Alright, we need a crypt incursion here. It only gains us 6 life, I think. Is another bolt or is it charmer dead? I feel like we're probably gonna get another turn out of this. Thought scour me or him? Me. Then we get to brutality. We're going to be at 4, going back up to 6. So we kill the crabs, that's good for us. 2 cards left in his hand. Let's see, next turn, 4 mana, just cut. Think I'm gonna start with an escalated brutality, discarding Inquisition, and then probably just a Mesmeric Orb. Scalding Tarn. Okay, wait, so we didn't make a land drop this turn, so we could play the, we can play the crab, but then if we turn Oboro and play it, we cannot play the orb, so we'll just put the orb. And hope he doesn't mill any phoenixes. But even if he does, he's unlikely to be able to cast it or recur it. I'm going to start with eluding. I'm going to discard the Tarn. Down to 24 cards, so we don't need that much more to kill him. Not Manamorphose. Ugh, okay. So there's a good chance he brings Phoenix back. Hopefully it's only one. But he's gonna get to cast another Faithless Looting. So yeah, Pyromancer Ascension, pretty powerful. Needs like a bolt or a fiery temper. All right, looting is good for us. I feel like he's gonna find something to kill us. I needed him not to find Manamorphose, but I guess he had 4 looks, 5 looks with a draw step. Alright, That's good enough. But the Pyromancer Ascension, I think, set address a little bit better. Not even convinced the Pyromancer Ascension's that great. Let's see. So it's putting Crypt Incursion and Set Adrift. So play one of each. I guess the Crypt Incursion is pretty bad post board because, like, we're very likely to have a Surgical. And oftentimes, Set Adrift just, like, puts it on top of their deck and then we can just mill it. So it's almost like a removal spell. I mean, we can deal them basically 10 damage for 0 mana, but not sure where we go from there. Like, the problem with this hand is, like, you just don't want to mill them until you have a Surgical. So, let's see. What can we do? It also doesn't even have a blue source. I don't know, it also feels wrong to mulligan a hand with two archive traps, but I feel like it's a move. It's very painful to do. Oh well, alright, try to find a Surgical. Gross. Gotta mulligan this. Alright, this hand's the best one yet. Hopefully it'll get there. Put this on the bottom. Lead with a Shelduck Isle. Take an extra paid, I guess. Two cards on top. If you didn't put them on top, I would probably play Water Grave tapped, but now we're just going to mill him. Let's see if we get a Phoenix. So the funny thing about his deck is by adding Pyromancer Ascension and Noxious Revival, you actually create an infinite combo with basically an active Ascension, Mana Morphos, and Noxious Revival. Alright, looks like he's going for the Phoenix this turn. Guess maybe it's slightly better Surgical in response to the looting because there's like a good chance that he has a Phoenix in his hand. function x times power. Field of run. Cuts them off. Let's see. And I think we just have to take his thing in the ice. Tether's thing in the ice or his ascension. I feel like the thing in the ice just kills us a lot quicker, so. Going truth. So we could bounce the ascension here. Not sure if that's worth it or not. I only need two counters to be active. I think it's worth it. It's pretty bad. Sure, let's mill them while they can't do anything about it. Then we can cast the extirpate on thing in the ice. Shoot. Ugh, I should not have tapped Shell Dock. That was a misplay. So we don't get punished. Yeah, I would have extirpated the is it charm. Or the thing in the ice. So he has two things in his graveyard, so he has two left in his deck. Basically, just need to draw like a mission briefing or something to mill him. Our character type's good. Now it's like really tough for him to cast like looting spells because it's just like, well, okay, I guess you can always choose not to copy. So he has two thing in the ices in his graveyard, two left in his hand slash deck. What other win conditions does he have? He's like, well, play so he does need to play four spells. So I guess he just doesn't copy. I mean, I guess he only needs like two attacks. Yeah, that was a punt tapping the shell duck aisle. Okay, I don't mind an ancestral recall. And archive trap for the win. Must be nice to be me. Ah, shoot. I cannot field a ruin basic. So this game's not quite over yet. All right, well, let's just extirpate his thing in the ice. And kill his other thing in the ice. Oh, well, he's out. That's fine, because then we still win. Let's run that back. Set of Drift is an Echoing Truth are like not great, but like it's either those cards or we could play something like Mesmeric Orb or Ensnaring Bridge. Did I take a picture of his deck? Nope, that was the last guy. Yeah, I didn't see if he like brought in the artifact hate. Like usually they have like three abrades. Like if they don't have and Ceremonious Rejection, if they don't have that, Ensnaring Bridge is really good against Thing in the Ice. Because he also has the Pyromancer Ascension angle. We'll try this. The bounce spells are good against Thing in the Ice, and they're okay against Pyromancer Ascension. Alright, so we have a Surgical and a Push. Those are the most important cards. Hopefully, we can find a land. Double top. So we found the land. We don't need to play the Visions from Beyond now, so I'm probably getting a Watery Grave. There's a chance he plays Thing in the Ice, in which case I might Fatal Push. I'm playing Glimpse next turn. Almost certainly. So return the Pyromancer's Ascension and play it. It's tough because I don't have a second Surgical for Phoenix. It's 14 cards in his library. I don't think the Ascension is necessarily that good. It's basically just a bunch of cantrips, but like if we answer all the things he's doing, then we'll be fine. Let's try again. And then the next go around, our Visions will be a draw three. Still no Phoenix, huh? It's pretty interesting. And he didn't cast anything. So that's very curious. Maybe he was holding up like something like Dispel. Alright, so now he's going to bin some Phoenixes. Two Fiery Tempers. Serum Visions, yep. So recall. Jeez, no land. That's really bad. We can set a drift. No, we wouldn't need a surgical in to set a drift. I think that's okay. So options are Inquisition or surgical into set adrift. Yeah, I guess I gotta get this stupid thing off the board now. So I will Inquisition his thing in the ice. Should have at least two to three left in his deck. We cared, we could also surgical the Ascension once we put it on top of his library. Oh, interesting, he had a Noxious Revival. So he actually could have countered it. Revival, Bolt, Loot. All right, so what does he have for Wind Cadence left? He has a couple Phoenixes and one Crackling Drake. So he can Noxious back one of his creatures, in which case we'll surgical it. And if not, I think we draw step surgical his Ascension. So I surgical his Ascension, he Noxious Revivals to counter my surgical, and I surgical it again. It does put us down to seven. Whereas I let him play the Ascension, then. Also go for Faithless Looting here. Going to seven's fine. Call. So we can Inquisition him next turn, but if we don't do anything this turn, he plays Ascension, plays Looting. Yeah, I think this is fine because outside of Pyromancer or Ascension, there's really not much he's doing that's very scary to us. So we will just trade the two surgicals for his Revival and Ascension in his hand. Looting, and he has no more Noxious Revival, so we just leave everything in his graveyard. Like everything else, we handle as creatures basically. So I'm not too worried. Take a brutality to gain some life. And yeah. The Inquisition him here. He bolts us, and hopefully he has another relevant spell. Okay. I don't know how I missed that one. But I guess we're fine. Yeah, I must not have exiled the last ascension. Arclight Phoenix. Yeah, that might be a problem. Can you escalate is the question. Yes. So I will do all three modes. Discarding watery fatal push and dismember. And then we can hard cast archive trap. Okay, this is the win right here. I'll do it on his upkeep, I suppose. Force him to search, trap, mission briefing trap. This thing is sweet. Could have Izzet Charm here, but hopefully he's out of win conditions. I think it was right to go for it. Like, yeah, there's not much we can do against Izzet Charm. I mean, I guess we could have waited. But let's see if he can just kill himself for us. One card in his library. Needs the... Like, I guess if he played Phoenix this turn, he could just actually just beat us. But... Now he needs, like, Bolt into Phoenix. Cool, got there. Alright, back for round four. We lost another die roll. I think that's... We've lost every die roll, so... Let's see what we can do. All right, looks like it's probably Shadow. Bridge. Let's see, Grixis Shadow. No creature is good for us. And it doesn't really matter if we scry because we're just going to mill him, so. Keep a shadow on top. Hopefully he plays shadows and not delve creatures. He's gonna get to take our recall, which is unfortunate. Play one delve creature. Brutality him. Yeah, I think it's fine. Get rid of his stubborn denial. Alright, we need to mill 13 cards to be able to play this bridge. Easier said than done. Great draw. Come on. No Snapcaster Mage, no Snapcaster Mage. Yes. Oh wait, that was silly. I don't know why I thought we could draw three there. Well, think I'm gonna hold off on the Field of Ruin. Like we could hit his red source. He's like holding up stubborn or something. I'd rather be able to field when I had draw an archive trap. Like, he didn't loot, so he's probably holding up stubborn. It's gonna be hard to beat. Crypt incursion. He has one creature in his graveyard? Your hand. Play this land. And probably play the Crypt Incursion instead, maybe? I don't know. Play the Battle Rage. Let's Crab. Block and Field of Ruin. We'll still land on Stubborn Denial, so Search Bell, it doesn't like counter that kind of, so I guess I'll just hold it. He milled both of his Battle Rages. Six to cast something off the shell dock. Okay, and we're dead. Let's surgical his stubborn denial. See if he did in fact have it. Alright, Grixis Shadow. So you can either leave bridge or take it out. I'm gonna leave bridge because the GP winning list, they basically cut all their Culligan's commands. They only had like one command, one Embraid post board. So let's try that. We actually do wanna keep an extraction to extract all their big threats. Crypt Incursion's bad. And then I guess it's like crab and mesmeric orb. You don't really want to mill them. You just want to mill them in big chunks when you like after they like they play their delve creatures or whatever. What else can we cut? Extirpate can also mess with their like Snapcaster Mages, obviously, and like their Braids and Colgan's commands to make sure your bridge survives. So one more cut. Brutality. Pick up a Field of Ruin. I'll just do that. Give this a shot. This hand's not very good, so we're just gonna take the looting. Question is, are we going to archive trap? The Field of Ruins, so we can do it later. He's going to Brutality next turn, probably, so I'm just going to do this now. Unfortunately, we did not mill a Gurmag Angler. So we could, let's just put one of these mission briefings. An island. I don't think there's anything worth surgicaling. Island girl. So, like, yeah, we could have kept the trap. He still would have been able to play the Gurmag, I think. He's 11 cards. I guess maybe it could have waited, given us another turn. Extirpate. Could exile the lootings now. fine. I still rather go after their threats. I will draw step surgical looting now. And dead skis. Alright, we get to play first. We still haven't faced any like bi matchups like Tron or Valakut, so please have this be one of those decks. Blue Red Prison. I have no idea how to play this matchup. So it's between Crucible and a redraw. So what does Crucible do? He can recur Ghost Quarters and Tech Etches. I don't really care. So I could just take a bobble. I'll take a bobble and surgical it. And he drew a welding jar. So he can ruins baubles. Okay, so yeah, I guess the key card in this matchup is Academy Ruins. I need to make sure I stop him from replaying it, otherwise I can't actually mill him out. But we can leave the bauble, I think. I don't really care if he recurs it. We can mission briefing surgical as Tolaria West. Or next turn we can end step Field of Ruin and next turn mission briefing Glimpse. Yeah, here's the problem is that, like, he's gonna basically assemble, he's gonna Teleria West for Academy Ruins and have Crucible, so maybe we're supposed to take the Crucible. But yeah, basically, we just need to kill his Academy Ruins and Surgical it at some point if we don't kill the Crucible. So just play Teleria West. And decided it's worth Field of Ruining here. It opens up Glimpse next turn. If I want to take that option. So I can mission briefing glimpse, or I can could surgical as inventor's bear. This crucible of the world doesn't really do that much. Think I'm just gonna glimpse him and hope to mill the Academy Ruins. Like, even if he assembles Academy Ruins, we still have some time. Matter. Mission briefing. Jeez. Top both of these. I can shuffle away the glimpse. If I want. Right, nice. I hit the Academy Ruins. Okay, I guess that's. Just means he's gonna Crucible it. Which is fine, because then we just Field of Ruin in. His Academy Ruins the turn before he's about to die. Transmutes here. What do we get? All I have to do is hold this Field of Ruin in my hand. Chalice, it's fine. Crucible is fine. Academy Ruins. Okay, so I just win. I just untap Glimpse, Field of Ruin, the Academy. No idea how to sideboard for this matchup. Creature stuff's definitely gotta go. Like, they have planeswalkers. I assume, yeah, Surgical is gonna be really good. We want answers to Chalice of the Void. So basically, it's brutality, which does very little, I think, right? Like, it hits whir, and everything else is just useless. That's fine. I think this should be a pretty good matchup. Like, so the key card is Academy Ruins that we literally can't beat if he has it out. So we have Field of Ruin for it, and we obviously can just like randomly mill it. And then he has Chalices, but we have three answers to it, plus mission briefings. So. So this is a blue-black build. I'm gonna probably try a green build. The downside to the green build, I think, is your mana is a little bit worse, and I don't think you can play Inquisition. Playing Inquisition in this deck is already somewhat dicey. We cycle the visions. Like, having said, a drift is not bad because it answers Chalice. Second set of drift is potentially useless. So, like, even if he had another land, what does his hand do? Doesn't do that much. Like, we also need to have bad black source. I'm gonna try for a mulligan. And this one's a keep. Bottom that. See what we're working with here. So he has EE, Spellskite, or if new agent. I think we just say were. If new zero. Curious what the EE on zero play. Looks like it brought in size. So, this is my Tezzeret, which is really bad for us. Okay, so that's why he played it. Okay, I should have been less liberal with my life total. 11 cards. Start by cycling this. Senator doesn't even do anything against Spellskite. I guess we're just dead. I probably didn't think this one too through. Like, I'm not sure what I could have done. Like, I could have taken Spellskite and then put a land on top of his library to delay the Tezzeret, but I think it's going to be hard to beat. I guess what I could have done was I could have didn't deal myself so much damage, and then this turn I could have gotten Glimpse, Set Adrift. I'm not sure if I had enough cards in my graveyard. I guess let's play this mission briefing and see if we can searchable him. Brought in Revoker, Spellskite. What does Revoker do? I guess it just beats down. So, for these kills, Spellskite. The best. Fatal Push. There's also Psy. A lot of delve, but I do want to be able to kill Psy and Spellskite. There are too many conditions around it. Mulligan, like, just a bunch of lands. Sounds good. Archive Trap. This is tough. I guess we just shuffle it away, play Inquisition. Yeah. Like, the turn on Inquisition is just so much more powerful, and we have a Mesmeric Orb to try to turn on our Visions of Beyond. I think I'll take the Bauble. Like, Tezzeret's the scary card here. Could take this Spellskite. I'll just take the Bauble. Yeah, being weak to Planeswalkers is a major reason to add Assassin's Trophy. Here's we're just gonna murderous cut. And stuff. So what's interesting is he got steam vents. So he can't even cast the agent of Bolas. Is that what that means? And he needs a couple more mana to use the Inventor's Fair. I think I'm just gonna cycle this vision. We can mission briefing the murderous cut next turn. EE2. He's gonna crack his E. No? Okay, I guess he has another island. That's fine. Mission briefing. Oh shit, I just realized he has cage in play. So, this doesn't do very much. Don't think we want either of these then. I think the size is going to kill us then. Maybe I was supposed to bring in Knight of Souls Betrayal or Damnation. four bottled cloister. Okay. Or Witchbane Orb. That's pretty good. I don't think we can win this one. Maybe we were supposed to take Cage. So, like, what does Cage do? It just turns off Mission Briefing, which is pretty important. Oh, yeah, you found a Mox. Alright, we're just gonna scoop here. That's going to be the video series. Unfortunately, we went 2-3. We did play against Artifact Burn and Grixis Whir, which are kind of weird, fringy matchups. I think this deck is close to being good, or it might already be good. I don't know that it's great. So I'm going to potentially try like a green splash for Assassin's Trophy and see if that might be good. All right. Thanks for watching.